I had just graduated from Brown University and was on my way to Stanford, and I'd come back for the summer to Nairobi. To stay with my parents. Barack was on his way to Harvard University, Harvard Law. I was in my room reading a book, The Devil Drives by Fawn Brody, and I heard the crunching sound of gravel outside. I knew a car had arrived. And the door opened. My mother was in the door, but she was trembling. It was like there was this emotion. She said to me, "Mark, your brother from America is here. Your brother Barack from America, he's here to see you." I stood up and I walked into the living room and I saw this this person who looked almost exactly like me with a bigger afro than me. And he was sitting on the seat and he was taller than me. And he stood up and he said, "Hi, I'm Barack." It was like all these skeletons in the closet were clanking in the background, you know. My mind wanted to shut out my past, but it had grown into a menacing presence, a hungry lion hidden in elephant grass.
Be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour.
A hungry lion hidden in elephant grass. Barack stood in front of a car, I believe a Volkswagen. The devil drives me.
The devil drives me. The devil drives me.
In the sunlight, I could see him better than I had the last time. He was taller and thinner than me, with a huge mass of unkempt hair. We shook hands somewhat awkwardly. At the time I said Barack, I said Barack, as everyone called our father.
Awake, awake, Deborah. Awake, awake, utter a song. Arise, Barack.
I said Barack.
And lead thy captivity captive, thou son of Abinoam.
Many years later, I learned that my brother preferred Barack. He didn't correct me, and I probably repeated this a number of times during our conversation. From the way he stood in the driveway that bright afternoon, rigid, his head tilted a little to the side as though listening to an inner voice, "I wanted to meet you," he had said during that first meeting. "Let's take a drive. I want to talk to you." The devil drives. What do you think of our father? What do you remember about him? His demeanor was cold. I felt, then, he was an arrogant bastard, but was too polite to say so to his face.